So talk briefly during the last presentation about our developments, sort of the city on there, it's with the subway tunnel up Colgrave. They focused on the sort of Hopple Street or Smith Washington Station, then we looked at the Cincinnati State Station and how we could use that day to not just serve Cincinnati State, but also serve Smith Washington and create some viable connectivity between the two, between the interstation and the...
Which right now there is actually an existing promoter station for Cincinnati State, but they have a plan to move right here. So they're saying that there's one here, and that there, there is one, for Cincinnati State up there.
So it's only actually moved a few, a couple hundred yards, that's 100 yards away from where the O-Dot land where they put it.
So, over here.
I think we'll sort of dive into the, more, less of the specifics, more of the overall theme here is that we mentioned briefly the connectivity between the two. And that's what the entire development is in. Both creating not only a physical connection between the neighborhoods, but then the thing that I this connection that will help encourage people to actually travel to.
And that's why we got into this capital freeway more than just a bridge for Colerain to connect from Central Parkway back to Colerain. This capital will make it so people will actually walk through this space and not, you know, use the pedestrian sidewalk across the bridge. We'll use this space for more than a bridge of use. It's literally an extension of the equipment area down.
There are some things about the road bridge and the train station, the train bridge over the highway. We combine all these things into one sort of superstructure that's made the highway. Not only have those different things, but also things that from there we get into aside from the actual train station and the bridge we have, we took a separate focus to develop the vicinity of the station. We have two specific projects we looked at in proposing. So there are four separate buildings, the buildings in white, other buildings that we proposed as new construction. And two of these buildings we looked at very specifically. That's what we proposed right here. The first one we looked at not only renovating the crossing building, which is the building seen here in the middle, we also proposed an addition to that building. And the sort of overall program of this building was to return some sort of manufacturing and distribution to the existing crossing building, because that's sort of what the structure that exists there is definitely inclined to suit. But also proposing a new addition of the palace with Class A office space, maybe a showroom or a store at the bottom, because then vertically integrate some sort of factory, whatever produces and distributes. So we have the offices that have the factory, designs to produce the same products, and the showroom is going to sell the products, showcase the products, all within the one center.
I looked at this building over here, which is at the bottom of the poster down here, which I was looking at ideas for some retail at the bottom of that. The bottom, the back side, the north side would be some more office, and then the square foot in front would be some sort of exhibit space, cultural center museum that would integrate all the history of Camp Washington and to really get it. Try to draw the crowds to Camp Washington from our library proposal. Actually, it exists. Things go. And we're doing somewhat similar things with this building here and that building there with some Orange Street retail to really get people from Cincinnati State to be able to come down to this area and use some of these facilities and kind of pull people into Camp Washington.
About the proposing, between a job, sort of a new job center and a cultural area, or a cultural center, that would be a catalyst for this immediate area to redevelop, combined with the new train station.
We looked at issues for having the transition come up above ground, go over 75, kind of opposite of what they did in the previous project, and we got a little bit different numbers than they did. Things out. We looked at the existing subway. It's about 16 feet from tracks to the top curvature of the roof, and there's about 2 feet of concrete above that, and then there's also a parkway. So it's really about 18-foot incline. And we did that over 192 feet.
That was a 7.3% grade to get from the base of the tunnel where it's put on. We also looked at this intersection line, the whole way up a little bit. We decided to have a little bit to sort of lessen the burden on either end. We brought up the 7.3% grade to get into the platforms where it isn't level. So it begins to turn. We go back to the existing ODOT.
I think we took I-75 down at 8 feet. So we didn't actually have that much cut. And we got to use cut over the gradual grade.
For perspective, the topography lines this on the right foot, it's a 1-to-30-second scale.
And the clearance of the bridge is still adequate for the highway bridge. It's about
16 feet, which is the ODOT standard. And there's actually, there's a meeting between 4 to 6 feet of structure and ground between above that holds up the bridge.